What's 30? What's 30 seconds? What's 15? What's 10? What's 7?
7?
Yeah. Wrong. 9. It's this.
30 seconds.
So watch out for that. Watch out for his move. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Rams Rewind. We've got ourselves a fun show for you tonight. We got men's basketball on tap. We've got women's and men's volleyball in the semifinals. We have a feature to get you to learn more about your Ryerson Rams. But first, it's those men's basketball trying to take on the Brock Badgers, looking to defeat them on their home court in St. Catharines. The Rams, of course, lost to the Badgers earlier this year at Coca-Cola Court. Let's see what we get from the Rams in St. Catharines. First quarter action. A little bit of fog to start things off, but that doesn't matter to Manny. He takes the contact and gets the layup to go. Darisa now setting up something on offense. Kicks it to Phil Vujudinovic in the corner, and you can count all three of those from the Serbian sniper. Rams getting it on defense. JV Mukama with a nice slam. Takes it all the way. Look at that jam. That boy's got ups. That's what I'm talking about. Rams with an early lead in the first. There's Darisa again with a beautiful three-pointer. Now check this play out. Darisa gets hammered by Daniel Gotti. Was feeling it on his way to the bench. Stayed in the game with a shoulder injury and muscled his way through. Second quarter now. Here's Charvis looking for a screen from Nagam, but we'll take it all the way on his own for a nice little reverse layup. Darisa finding Phil Vujudinovic again. This guy was draining threes left, right, and center for the Rams all game. The Rams unable to convert there. Darisa with the offensive board. Charvis driving, contact, layup. Rams are dominating in the first half. Here's Vujudinovic, finds JV Mukama in the corner. Splash. What else do you expect from Mukama? Miles Charvis working his way inside. Beautiful taking the contact and making the layup, but Brock would not go away in this one. Drains a three in the corner there. Daniel Gotti trying to make something happen on offense. Another corner three to bring the Badgers within 3 points. Rams trying to keep their lead. Nagam with a slip screen. Roshan Roberts taking it all the way to the cup. Wants the foul, doesn't get the call, but it doesn't matter. Al Gotti now looking to make something happen on offense. Kicks it outside. Some swings from the Badgers. Look at that dish. What a find from Simpson to Danny Al Gotti. Al Gotti now with an unfortunate turnover. It's a jump ball. Ryerson possession. What they would do on that possession is what you would expect. Moving the ball around nicely. Looking for the wide open shot, and it's the Serbian sniper. Left-handed, locked in, and that would be the dagger for the Ryerson Rams. They would take this game 69-63, knocking off the Badgers at their home court. An amazing victory for this Rams team, who's going on to face the Carlton Ravens. Darisa with 19, 5, and 3. Charvis, 15 points of his own. Mukama doing well on the glass. And of course, Phil Vujudinovic, 16 points, was making it rain from downtown. Al Gotti with 20 points of his own, but that wasn't enough as Ryerson takes this game against the Badgers. Now, the Rams are advancing to the final against the Ravens in the Ravens' nest. Now, Ryerson knocked off Carlton last time they faced off in the OUA final, defeating them for their back-to-back OUA championship. But this team that Carlton has put on the floor is looking like they are ready to play. Another undefeated season under head coach Dave Smart, 23-0. They have won 9 of the last 15 Wilson Cups. Unbelievable. Of course, both of those silvers coming to losses against the Ryerson Rams. Quality that the Rams have put on the court to beat the Ravens, but it's going to be a tough matchup for them as they are going to have to be tough to come out victorious. But Ryerson has faced adversity before and will be ready to head into the final against Carlton. We wish the boys best of luck for that game. But don't go away. We have men's hockey team just straight flexing with awards, as well as a story on our very own Matt Mistele. He had an incredible season this year. Don't go away. We'll be back with more Rams Rewind. What's going on, folks? We back with more Rams Rewind. Now, the men's hockey team unfortunately had their season end in another second round loss. However, the plethora of awards that this team has won from their play this season is unfathomable. We're going to start with Captain Alex Basso. He had an incredible year for the Rams, leading this team on the blue line as he was just an offensive machine. 28 points in 24 games this year. One of the best players in Canada. Basso won defenseman and player of the year in the OUA, as well as a second team All-Canadian. He was one of the top players in Canada, like I mentioned, and was absolutely on fire at all times. 14 goals for the Rams. Look at this, just power. Straight captain, straight leadership. And that's what you want from a guy like Alex Basso. Matt Mistele and Kevin Leth, two of his teammates, had honors of their own. Leth was an all-rookie team selection with 21 points in 28 games. Mistele was named to the second team All-Canadian, and he had 33 points in, get this, 18 games. And although he was injured at the end of the season, still finished as one of the top scorers in the OUA. Mistele will be a key part of this team next season and moving forward in this program. He has been absolute quality on the ice for the Rams this season. Missed 10 games due to injury. Had he had those 10 games, it was likely that Mistele would have broken records. But with more on his decision to come to Ryerson and his injury this year, we're going to talk to Matt Mistele.
For Matt Mistele, the road to Ryerson has been one that not many are familiar with. A Memorial Cup champion, a former draft pick of the Los Angeles Kings, as well as catching the attention of the Boston Bruins, the National Hockey League didn't seem out of the picture for Mistele. Despite the impressive resume, he committed with the Rams in 2016, seeking to further his education, as well as continuing to play the sport he loves.
I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do, but I knew school was always in the back of my mind, and my parents are both teachers and stuff like that, and it's important to me. And so I just decided to go to school, and I think it was a great choice. It was either I signed an NHL contract and got 3 years, or I went to school. Obviously, the OHL gives everyone a great school package, and it's good hockey here, and I think people are starting to realize that you can go to school and get your degree, and if you're good enough, hockey will be there after. And that was kind of my mentality, is I'm confident in the player I am, and I wanted to go to school, and if it works out after, it works out, and if not, I have my degree, and I can start my life.
And, you know, fortunate for us, you know, we were in the right place at the right time, and, you know, he decided to commit to us, went to camp with Boston. We obviously stayed in touch with him and wished him the best, and when he found out he wasn't going to receive an NHL offer, he decided to come back and pursue his degree in, you know, criminology, and he's been a, you know, tremendous asset for us, both on and off the ice.
So far, Mistele has surpassed expectations. With 33 points in 18 games, he was one of the top scorers in the OUA, on pace to break team records. However, his dominant start came to a halt at the onset of 2018.
Well, it's as cold as you can possibly get in downtown Toronto today. But boy, are we ever red hot and ready to go inside. The Ryerson Rams, winners of four straight.
Just had a power play, and maybe I stayed out there a little too long, but I went in for a shot and got tripped up, and as I was trying to get up, the guy kind of skated over my wrist.
Looks to pass out again. Mistele shoots. That's blocked. Tries another one, and this time it skitters wide as Di Tomas Grasso keeps it going. Mistele's lost all. Oh, that's not good.
Right away, I kind of knew it was bad, so I just grabbed it and tried to hold the blood in and skate it off. Luckily, our doctor was awesome, and I went and got emergency surgery right after, so could have been a lot worse, but it was a fluke play and nothing you could do about it.
He's got all the casts off, and he's starting his rehab and starting to build towards next season. And I think we've got a highly motivated player that's going to come in with a little bit of something to prove for next year.
I just started therapy this week, and hopefully I'll get some strength back in it. Obviously it's weak right now, but my goal is to be back for next year, and I'm sure I will be. Hopefully my best games are to come in the future, and it's been good up until this point, and hopefully we can continue for sure.
What adversity from Matt Mistele. He's going to be a great member for the Rams. But coming up after the break, it's volleyball playoffs. Both teams still alive, chasing championships. It's banner season, folks. You won't want to miss it. Hello and welcome back. Now, OUA semifinals, the Ryerson Rams men's volleyball team is taking on the Queens Gaels. These two teams split their regular season games, so let's see what happens in what's going to likely be a tight matchup between the Rams and Gaels. Let's take you now to Hamilton, where we get a great game between Ryerson. Now, the men's volleyball team has been struggling all season. In their last game against Nipissing, they came out with a loss. But we're going to go into the first set. Lucas Coleman with a heavy serve, handled well by Queens. Jack Pickman gets the kill in the middle. Not to worry, though. The Rams have a pretty good middle of their own. It's Brett Whitley scoring on the set from Anagostopoulos. Now 13-8 Rams. Davis Power puts some mustard on this one. But the Gaels show some hustle on defense, able to recover and send it back the free ball. But if you try once, try again, says Simon Davis Power, as he will not be denied. Rams up 6. Now that lead wouldn't last, though. Now set points for Queens and Coleman. Coleman's serve is wide. Queens take the first set, set 2. Queens already up 9-4. Bump, set, Coleman with the cross-court kill. Rams within striking distance, 13-7 in favor of Queens. Brendan Kewen gets a little fancy with his shot down the line, but Queens picks it up. But hey, Kewen, I like that tip shot. Here's one of my own. That fools the Gaels. Point Ryerson. Queens take a 6-point lead into the technical timeout. Rams now playing catch-up late in the set, and who else do they look to other than Lucas Coleman? Not once, but twice in this rally. Still a 6-point advantage for the Gaels. Navarit Suhan's tip is too easy for Queens, and they take advantage. It's Mitchell Neurit with a big swing on the right side. Set point now for Queens. Peckman with the serve, and a tight pass from Jackson Dunning joust at the net, picked up by Queens. Set 3 action now. It is do or die for the Rams if they want to play for an OUA banner. Peckman with the tip shot. That falls. Gaels still trail by 4. Now 23-17 for the Rams. Coleman's soft touch is handled well by Queens. Another second chance opportunity for the Rams, and they went back to Coleman. Fourth set. Suhan and Anagostopoulos can't connect in the middle, and it's Trentz again, able to fix the tight set and score. Ryerson, though, still lead 11-7. Now a 3-point lead later in the set for Ryerson. Coleman with the pipe, and it's too much for Trentz to handle. Rams go up by 4. Set point. Now with Ryerson trying to force a fifth, Brett Whittles. Of course, we're doing 5 sets in the hammer. Onto the fifth set, they get the free ball, and Rams trail by 2 on the next play. They show some good defense of their own, but the Gaels take advantage of the free ball, and it's Neurit with the kill. Gaels would lead all the way to match point. Rams, again, scrambling on D. They go out of the system to Coleman, who tries to recycle off the block, but Ryerson can't send the ball back as the Gaels would win this matchup. That would be all she wrote for the Rams' hopes on playing in the OUA final. 21 points, 20 kills for Hutchison. Peckman had a fantastic game of their own. Coleman led all players with 30 points and was the player of the game. Lucas Coleman leading this team as he's done all year. We'd like to congratulate the men's team on a fantastic season, but it's not over yet. We have an undefeated team on the line here, folks. It's women's volleyball. They're facing off against the Western Mustangs in the semifinal at Coca-Cola Court. Let's head there now. Let's see what these Rams women can do. And we know what they've been up to all season, and that's quality play. In the first, there's Western with a nice attack on the outside. That's Melissa Langenner. Now Rams, looking to make something happen. Beautiful attack from Lauren Veltman on the outside. Rams are trailing in this first set. A bump, set, nice attack, met by the double block from Ryerson, but Western would recover, sending over the free ball. Longman to Alicia Lamb, and a nice tip shot on the outside by Ryerson. Rams still down 8 in this set as Western. Nice attack from the backcourt, but that would be out of bounds as they would take the first set, Western, and they're up 1-0. There's Vernon with a nice double block there, and on the outside, it's Kelsey Veltman, sister of Lauren Veltman. We've got a little bit of sister action here in the semifinal, folks. Kate Ferguson with the serve. Ryerson looking to take advantage. It's Vernon met with the block as Western with a beautiful chance to hit the floor there. Ryerson now has to send over the three ball. Western wanted a nice tip and maneuver there from the Mustangs, but unable to get the point. Now, outside, there's Veltman again. She makes a nice attack to give the Rams a lead 24-16, and they would take the second set. On to the third we go. It's Ryerson. A nice back set and work. Come on, what do you expect? A left-handed attack, beautiful, just inside the line. Western, with a nice attack of their own, that finds the floor. It's Kelsey Veltman again with a nice attack. Great dig and defense from Ryerson, and on the outside, it's Lauren Veltman. The Veltman sisters just going at it. Tick for tack here in this semifinal matchup. Ryerson setting up Veltman again, but a nice double block there as that finds the floor. Western keeping themselves alive, but unfortunately losing that one in this third set. Fourth set we go. Western getting aggressive in the first, at the beginning of this one, but it was all Ryerson in this matchup. A nice attack there from the outside. They want to keep their season alive, but it was the Rams who kept this game within reach, and there's Vernon with a nice double-handed block. She was one of the best players for the Rams all season, and who else do you expect to get the winning point? It's Tiana Vernon again. A double-handed stuff blocked at the line as the Rams would take this game 3-1. Veltman for the Western Mustangs, 16.5 points, 12 kills. Veltman for the Ryerson Rams, 20 points, 18 kills, 11 digs. Lauren Veltman facing off against her sister Kelsey, and it's Lauren who gets the bragging rights in this matchup. It's fortunate now that the Rams are moving on towards the final. We have the U Sports Women's Volleyball National Championships. It's these women, folks. We should be supporting them tenfold. They've had an undefeated season. They're in Quebec City Friday, March the 16th against the UBC Okanagan Heat. We'll be cheering these ladies on until their season is over, but we don't want it to end anytime soon. Keep us entertained. We need more sports here at Ryerson. So good luck to the women on that. We'll be back next week with more Rams Rewind. Thank you so much for joining us on this week's episode, and we'll see you next week, folks.